our eyes will open and begin to understand the scriptures. No, and when we understand the scriptures, the Bible says you study the scriptures thinking that in them is eternal life. But the scriptures testify about me. Everything the scripture talk about, Jesus fulfilled it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Even the law, even the people who are preaching the law, and they were dictating and they crucified Jesus based on the law was there so that Jesus can fulfill it and bring the right pattern of Christocentric, praising Jesus. And that's why the church needs the revelation, so that when you gain in revelation, there is no problem. But when you boast in foolishness, hallelujah, then you will languish in the same. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Mtoto ambaye alikuwa mwerevu shuleni hata alikuwa anaambia mwalimu hiyo sababu ni rahisi, let me nifanye wewe tulia. And then unaenda kwa ubao and you have confidence mwalimu ako hapo, but you can still teach and say formula ni hii and you unaenda mpaka mwisho.
Amen.
Unapata iko sawa, you get it. Hallelujah. So when you have revelation, when you have visions, you will not even fear to preach in my presence.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise King Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us focus on the stripes. I told you when learning about prayer that it is good when we are learning. Hallelujah. It is good we know how to pray. And then I said when we pray, we must apply the word. We must always apply the word. Hallelujah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 5 pastors here for now. I want pastors to come here at the altar. Pujeni tu hapo kwa madhabahu. Let me do some demonstration here. Hallelujah. Pujeni tu hapo kwa madhabahu kwa nyuma katika jina la Yesu Kristo. In the name of our Lord Jesus. So let's go. Praise King Jesus. I want us just to stand on the same and then to debate na pas kidogo to have enough space. Hallelujah. Now, because they are 5, those who are here, hallelujah, they are 5 for now. I want 5 people to come here. I want 5 people willingly, before I call you, utapata mtu ametoka nyuma na mkida mingine tu mbele. Nataka watu watano wafikie kwa madhabahu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. 5 of them in the name of our Lord Jesus. And then make sure you angalia pastor. Choose one pastor. Just choose one pastor. Choose one pastor in the name of the Lord. Just choose one in the name of the Lord. Pastor, una mbaki bure. Kwa sababu ni mkali, sidiwa? Sema hapana, huyo atanilani. Hallelujah. Praise King Jesus. Hallelujah. Can I have one microphone ipeano kwa pastor? Pastor, chukua yo microphone. Tuwanda na pastor Msoti. Just give him that microphone. Wale wenye mmekuja, pigeni magoti. Hallelujah. Pigeni zitu magoti sasa. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo. I want us to pray. And we want to assume these who are here are sick. Na unajua Mungu anajua. Kama wewe leo mbaya na kuombea unapona.
Amen.
It's a demonstration and at the same time it's a reality.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to start by apostle. I want you to pray that he said you are mgonjo. Hallelujah.
So
that come home. And I want us to apply the word in the prayer so that the prayer can be powerful. Because when I talk about the prayer, I say you must apply the word. You must pray within the word. And you must also do one thing. You must be specific. Praise King Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go. Tuombe tafadhali. Tuanze hiyo. We are assuming it's any disease. Any disease.
Father, I want to thank you because of my brother. Jehovah, we thank you because already he is healed in the name of Jesus Christ. As per your word, King of all the glory, you say that by your stripes we are all healed in the name of Jesus. We declare, Father, that right now his body is okay, and in the name of Jesus Christ, you are well, my brother, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you because of done it, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Piga makofi tafadhali. God bless you. Pastor David, karibu.
Baba, katika jina la Yesu Kristo, nakushukuru kwa sababu ya ukuu wako mfalme. Nasema ni asante kwa sababu jinsi ambavyo unavyosema katika Zaburi 107 mfalme kuanzia 19 na 20 ya kwamba unapotuma neno la uponyaji mfalme wa ajabu, wakati huu Jehova inaenda kuondoa mfalme wa ajabu kila aina ya magonjwa katika sister huyu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Na nashukuru Mungu kwa sababu hakika umemtenda wema wako katika jina la Yesu Kristo, ninakushukuru.
Yes, unapiga makofi kwa kona. Amen na maisha ya kona.
Kwa jina la Yesu Kristo, imefunguliwa. Nenda.
Amen.
Asante. Pile makofi.
Hapa katika jina la Yesu Kristo natangaza uponyaji kwa huyu dada, kwa maana wewe ni mponyaji wetu, Jehovah King of Glory. You may heal her in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus.
Baba wetu na Mungu ishie milele, ya asante kwa sababu ya ndugu huyu ambaye mfalme amekuwa mgonjwa kwenda ni miaka mingi, lakini mfalme unenena vyema kwamba kwa msalaba yote yamekwisha, magonjwa yamekwisha, kwa utukufu wa jina lako. Asante maana umemponya, kwa jina la Yesu Kristo tumeomba. Amen. Wapigie makofi. Yes, makofi. Hallelujah. Kwa chini umepona, mleta ushuhuda Jumapili kwa jina la Yesu Kristo. Hallelujah. Yes, yes, hallelujah. Praise King Jesus. Mleta ushuhuda katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Kuna watu Mungu aliyesema alikuwa anamwambia, go and show yourselves to the priest. Hallelujah. Nowadays when people are healed, they don't come back. They don't come to show themselves back. Ana tumelea tu kwa anasema, eh? Hallelujah. So now I want us to begin by the stripes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the first person to pray, the first pastor to pray, he quoted a scripture and he said, I declare that you are healed, because your word says, by your stripes we were healed. Hallelujah. Somebody say, by his stripes we were healed. The second pastor quoted Psalms chapter 107 from verse 19 to 20, that I will send the word of healing and it will heal your diseases, and I will save you, rescue even from the graves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The third pastor, Pastor Owen alisema na kufungua enda. Praise King Jesus.
Amen.
And Pastor Dan alisema nini? Pokea uponyaji katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Good. And then finally kuna Pastor Gasin akasema wewe ni mzee lakini Mungu. Hallelujah. So all this is prayers, and some of these prayers we find them in churches. Hallelujah. And sometimes I can pray for you and maybe you are not healed and you say, pastor is weak, pastor does not operate with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So today, as we talk about the stripes, before we go to the blood of Jesus, if I will not go to the blood of Jesus today, there is no problem. But I will still continue with this. Hallelujah. Because there is a lot of dimensions here to enter into. Hallelujah. But now, let us focus on the stripes. Hallelujah. I want us to focus on the stripes. Can we read this verse again? I must go on boasting, although there is nothing to be gained, I will go on to visions and revelations of the Lord. When you read this same chapter, kuna mahali ambapo ukifika, you will realize that now Paul is showing us how Jesus was crucified, how he resurrected, and how he went to the third heaven. Hallelujah. Meaning there is first heaven, there is second heaven, and there is third heaven. First heaven is the atmosphere. Mahali ndege wa angani wanapitia. Mahali airplanes wanasafiri wakienda nchi zingine. The second heaven, we find the stars, the moon, and all those, the sun and all that. That is the second heaven. We found it last Sunday, Filippo Soma from the book of Genesis. Hallelujah. And then we have the third heaven. Third heaven is a place where the throne is. Hallelujah. Microphone ingine haraka. Where the throne is. The throne, where the throne of God has been set, that God will sit on that throne. And this God is God, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise King Jesus. Hivyo, as we understand this, message today, our lives will never be the same again. Our lives will never be the same again. Hallelujah. I want us to read Isaiah chapter 6, verse 10.
Hata katu wapo klinda. Nikitake wa mimi. Katu wapo ndio. Unaweza kule tukaya hapo. So that we can be very fast.
Isaiah chapter 6 verse 10 in the name of the Lord. Isaiah chapter 6 verse 10 in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Make the hearts of these people calloused. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word calloused is the word dull. Hallelujah. Dull. Not sensitive. Hallelujah. Make the heart of these people calloused. Make their ears dull and close their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their heart, and turn and be healed. Praise King Jesus.
Amen.
So he's talking about healing. And the message we are learning here is about the stripes and the blood. But now we are majorly focusing on the stripes before we go to focus on the blood. So anasema kwamba, make the hearts of these people calloused, make their ears dull and close their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hands. That's why I told you, it is dangerous when you understand the message I'm preaching with your mind. It is dangerous when you understand with your own intellect. You need to understand God with your heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because it is in the heart that the understanding of God is embedded. Hallelujah. Love your God with all your heart. Hallelujah. So listen to this. Make the heart of these people calloused. Make their eyes dull and close their eyes. Otherwise they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn and be healed. So what will provoke people to be healed? When they do what? When they understand with their hearts, when they hear with their ears, when they see with their eyes, that is what we call revelation and vision. Once they have taken and conceived it, we normally say that conception is perception. You only perceive what you conceive. Hallelujah. You only conceive what you receive and perceive what you